Hey guys, good morning. We're starting on the last day of the boat build. We've got three boats built, and now we're just doing some fine tuning. There's one of them over there. We've got one of them over here.
Nice to do.
And we've got one of them back over here. And we are basically putting a canopy system on them so that we'll be able to have a tarp, also putting a rudder system on them, putting some finishing hardware, rope cleats, so that we can tie them off and tie them to each other. So that's the build today. I'm going to document it for you. Welcome to Darrell in Tents.
Cross pipes so they slide in and out a little easier.
So we're just going to do that and tie it together.
Well,
are we going to glue it eventually?
These are glued. The others we peeled. So okay. We can take these down and put them back up.
I call the tongue suntanning.
Yeah. I'm thinking about traveling on the road.
Yeah, and the sun tanning days, we can take them down. Okay, so these are the pipes that are going to hold up the canopy. They're basically the structure for the canopy. This is Spanky. He's one of the nicest guys on the crew. The other guys are real jerks, actually, but not Spanky. And so anyway, we're sanding these down to be able to handle all of the joining hardware. So that's job one this morning, the structure for the canopy. So the T-fittings that are going to go at the ends of these pipes are just fitting tight, so because we're going to put them up and take them down on a regular basis, we're just narrowing the ends, tapering the ends so that they'll move in and out, and then we'll pin the adapters. So one of the considerations for the trip is how we get coffee down nine guys on a regular basis. So this pot will actually brew right at 36 cups per pot. So today we're taking this for a test drive. You actually boil water, bring the water to a rolling boil. Then you put coffee grounds in it. There's a certain ratio for it. We'll talk about that as the trip progresses. And you let that boil for a little bit, a couple minutes, and then you pour one cup of cold water into it. And the word is that the grounds just drop to the bottom. So cowboy coffee, they call it, and we're going to take it for a test drive.
So those got to be in the bottom.
So we're testing these just to make sure that the structural system will hold the canopy.
I think we should mark
based on what the weather is every day, whether it's rain or whether it's shine for multiple hours on a raft. I'm going to want to be able to get out from underneath the elements. So we're working on how many bunks. So we're going to have three guys per boat. And so this is the type of bunk that we're looking at. It's a rain fly. It's a cot. It's a mattress. It's really a pretty good setup for what we're doing, and we think we can get three on these boats easily, two towards the front of the boat and then one right back here towards the back of the boat. This is a 30-gallon water tank. It's just a barrel, but we're going to fill it with water from spigots, and if Red Cross recommendations are a gallon of water per person with three guys on a boat, a 30-gallon is good for 10 days, should be 10 days worth of water for three guys. So that may be the way to go, and then we're not taking water just out of the Missouri River, which could be somewhat questionable, but we'll filter it, but guys feel a little more comfortable filling a 30-gallon barrel with 30 gallons of spigot water and then filtering that. Then pulling it out of the Missouri River. So that's the plan so far. All right, William, what are we doing here?
Just attaching the oars.
All right. Seems simple enough. Okay.
Setting them in at 36 inches for now, and then probably have to adjust them once we get there. We don't know how deep the boat's going to sit.
All right, cool.
So we're going to put them in here now and then adjust as we go.
Do you think we can get three cots on these things?
We can get them on there.
And the crates with we're putting supplies, either individual guy supplies or communal supplies, cooking supplies.
Not a lot of room for roaming around.
Not a lot of roaming. Yeah, not going to go for a walk every day. All right.
You want to do that one up there? Burt Street Bugger here, William. Use the other end with the knock end goes on that end. The knot end. Just go from, just tie a knot on this thing and go around the tube and head underneath. There you go. And then through the eyelet.
And back to the loop.
Yep, from the bottom side.
And there then back go. Around the tube.
Then go back around it. Okay. Now, somebody grab this end down here and make sure. You put it through, just make a loop. Tie it around and then make it. You can tighten it, but it's just going to have to be. That's good. That's all it takes.
Great.
And pull that tight. Can you pull this up over for us? I've got some tape, but we just have to tape those things when we get to the finished product kind of deal. Okay. So that's good. So we can do the same thing on this eyelet and the next eyelet. And the one that's on the end has to be done a little different. It needs to be a little longer.
So if it's a nice day and we want a little breeze, we can always slide the rail up. Not the rail, but the tarp up the structure, like this side is. We can do that to both sides, or drop it if we're trying to keep wind or rain from coming inside the boat. So, got a little bit of flexibility once we get on the water. Okay, so back on the back here, where the near where the rudder is, we're going to run a cable that starts back here with a hook on it. That also the cable run all the way to the front of the boat with a similar contraption on the other side. And that way, with the hook there, we can actually pull, tie boats together, tie them off, pull them out of the river, whatever. And rather than just having it, you know, mounted to one end, it'll pull the whole structure, the whole raft, and not just one board off the raft. So that's the plan. So they're on the other side working the cable and threading that and determining where they're going to put the metal plate, the steel plate on that end. But that's what we're doing, and that's why we're doing it. We'll put four crates on each boat. One crate for each man and one crate that holds supplies. We know we're going to have one chair for the guy in the middle that's oaring, rowing. And then a couple of chairs that can be also placed just for convenience and comfort on the trip.
Put one right over the center and maybe put another one over here.
And the metal bar here is a flagpole that will be lifted and placed in that hole. Well, they're all built. We've got all the hardware on. We've got everything fitted for the canopies and the tarps and the rudders and the oars. And we put everything in to know where all the cots and all the gear is going to store. Now we're just ready for a test run. A couple of weeks, we're going to spend the night out and make sure we've got all the right equipment, all the right camping gear, and where it's all going to fit. The next morning, we load it all onto the boats, and we float downriver. So we're going to take this for a test drive in a couple weeks. Stay tuned. Thanks for watching. God bless.